Hello, everyone. My name is Medya Ghazizadeh. I'm a technical lead manager at Google, and I've been leading the minikube team since 2019. I'm so excited to share this series on minikube from introduction to advanced usage. So stay with me. Before anything, what is minikube? Minikube is a local Kubernetes tool that was developed by Google in 2016 and was donated to CNCF Foundation. According to CNCF survey, minikube is the most popular way to start a Kubernetes cluster. According to our own surveys from our users, minikube is mainly used for local development and followed by learning Kubernetes and followed by testing in their testing environments. Before you start a minikube cluster, you need to have a driver installed. For most of the users, Docker is good enough driver. But if for any reason you cannot install Docker or you do not want to install Docker, you have 13 other alternatives that might also have some extra features for advanced users. For a full list of the drivers, you can check our website, minikube-sigs.kates.io. But what is a driver? Kubernetes itself needs to be installed in a Linux environment. So if you have a Windows or a laptop, which is macOS, you do not have a Linux environment. So therefore, minikube creates a Linux environment virtually for you, either using a virtual machine or a container. So therefore, you need to have a technology installed that provides some sort of virtualization for you. In this tutorial, I'm going to be using Docker driver myself. First, you have to install minikube. Go ahead to the minikube website, click on Get Started, and then download minikube using the commands that minikube website provides you. I've already installed minikube and also Docker, and I'm going to just type minikube start. If you do not specify any configurations or flag, minikube will choose the best options for you. Here you can see minikube automatically chose the Docker driver for me because that was already installed and I was already running. But there are other options on my system that minikube preferred Docker over them. Minikube also selected the number of the CPUs and the memory for me. Also chose the Kubernetes version and the container runtime for my cluster. And also chose the default add-ons to be installed on my system as well. Now that we have our cluster running, we could interact with it with kubectl. That if you are familiar with kubectl or Kubernetes, it's the way to connect to your cluster. If you do not have kubectl installed, you could use the minikube's kubectl by running minikube kubectl dash dash and then the command that you want, simply like that. Now that we have minikube running and the cluster running, let's deploy an app to this. I'm going to use the minikube getting started guide on our website to deploy an application to it. In this case, I'm going to deploy an Nginx image to it. So I'm going to copy this, kubectl create deployment, hello minikube, with this image Nginx. And also going to create a service that will connect to the Nginx on port 80. So far, everything has been Kubernetes. And now let's see, let's use minikube command, minikube service list. We could see that minikube recognizes the service that we just deployed. And let's connect to this service using the minikube service, the name of the service, in this case, hello minikube. And there you go, minikube started, connected to this service and opened it in our browser. One tip I can give you, if you're on a corporate network, ensure you're not connected to a proxy, otherwise you might not see this page. Let me introduce you to some commands on minikube. If you are a beginner user, there are three good friends for you: minikube profile list, minikube status, and the dash dash help command. So any minikube command will have a dash dash help. Let's try them out. Minikube profile list. This will list me all of the clusters that I've installed or created on my local machine. Here I have one cluster using the Docker driver, using the Docker runtime, and you can see the Kubernetes version, and you can see the status and the number of the nodes. And you can see this is my active cluster as well. In the next episode, we're gonna cover multi-clusters and more advanced usages. Another command that I like the beginner users to get familiar with is the minikube status. This will tell you the internal component status for every component of minikube and Kubernetes. And then let's try out the --- help command on minikube profile list. You can see the profile list has two options. One of them is light, and one of them is output. And you could choose the output to be JSON or a table. So let's try the minikube profile list with a JSON output. This is useful if you want to use minikube in an embedded use. Now that we are discovering more minikube commands, let's discover adding a node to minikube to make our cluster multi-node. There are two ways to do that. You could either start a cluster with two nodes from the scratch, or if you already have a cluster, you want to add a node to it, you could simply say minikube node add. And this will add one worker node to our cluster with the same settings of the other nodes. If you want to change the settings, check out the minikube node --- help for more options. So we're gonna wait a few seconds for this new node to be up and running. So we can verify the node with profile list. You can see the nodes now shows two. And then you can verify that with kubectl command as well. Before we wrap up the first episode, I wanna show you how to stop minikube. So there are multiple ways to stop minikube. One, minikube stop, which is stops the current cluster. Minikube stop --- all stops all of the clusters if you have multiple clusters. A minikube pause, we're going to talk in the next episode. A minikube delete --- all, which will delete the cluster, including the Nginx or the app that we just deployed. But there's a nuclear option. If you want to delete everything that minikube has put on your system, including the cached images, you could do minikube delete --- all --- purged. This is not the recommended way, because every single time you start minikube, it will re-download all of those images again, which is going to be a little bit slower. That was the end of the first episode. I hope you stay tuned in for the next episodes. I have so many exciting new tips to share with you. Thank you very much.